What's up, guys? Twig46 here with the next episode of Silent Hunter 4. Now, I've given up completely on trying to keep track of what the heck episode I'm on. But, you know, it's the next episode. And where we last left off, we had successfully completed a patrol here, sunk a few ships there, and we were on our way to the... There you go, the new patrol route, or the new patrol zone, and this was our route, and along the way we've come across a ship, and we're gonna sink them. Now let's have a look at the weather. Very calm, very clear. Luckily we got the radar to help us out, so we're going flank speed. Basically bulldoze my way into this guy. He changed direction, that jerk. Alright. This is good for me, though. He's coming right at me. Quite. Little to the right. Little more. So I'm probably going to have to do an aft attack on this guy. Alright, so that's his line. Where's our torpedo situation? Aft attack it is. Okay. Go ahead and do the 90 now. Why not? It's 127, 128. Which is way the heck over here. Yeah, good enough. Get the turn started. That'd be fantastic. Look at that thing move. Isn't that beautiful? So majestic. The beautiful thing is the ocean. There's nothing going on from as far as the eye can see except for this. That's what makes it amazing.
Yes, sir. New course, 128. Yes,
sir. Beautiful. So we're gonna start leveling out on that course. Alright, and we're on our way. Beautiful. I love this game. It is so much fun. It's so relaxing, too. After playing those online multiplayer games that I play and coming to this, it's just so therapeutic because everything about it is me. You know, it's like it's not the team's fault if something goes wrong. It's my fault if something goes wrong. It's all me, up to me. Go ahead and do a Dexawash here. Well, not quite, but at least all the ballast tanks are more or less underwater. Reduces our profile a little bit. Let's try a little more.
New deck, 2, 4. Yes, sir.
Well, that's not what I wanted at all. Okay. That was funny. I just kind of flopped into the water. I don't know, I just love looking at the boat. It's just so beautiful. It's such a beautiful machine of death and destruction. Well, anyway, let's get back to business. We have this boat that's coming towards us. And... go ahead and dive. Slow this down for a minute. Put it to 5, where we're at. 5 kilometers to, or kilometers, 5 nautical miles to us. Here he comes. Everything is going according to plan. All right, so let's slow it down again. Get the sonar tracking him.
Merchant, closing, bearing, 1, 0, 4.
Okay. Just based on this engine sound, I'm going to say it's either a small split or a European modern composite, which I think that's what it's called. You know, the 5,000 tonner ship that I said was 4,500 last episode. That's what I'm going to guess it is, just based on the sound alone. Because it's fun to try to do that, you know, it adds to the game, and, you know, I won't say that there's much to this game, because there is. It's quite complicated, actually, if you don't know what you're doing, and it can change in an instant. I kind of wish now that I would be engaging more warship kind of stuffs for you guys, like, you know, the very, very, very first episode of this series where I died, actually. Because I was engaging a convoy of warships, and I've never seen anything like that, and it kind of freaked me out.
Merchant, bearing, 1, 0, 6, closing.
Okay, so 7.5 knots, we'll let him get close. Don't you dare turn.
Merchant,
now.
Bearing, 1, 0.
Oh, shoot.
7.
Clock. Thank you. Okay, hang on. I drank a little bit of wine, so it's a little bit harder for me to get the finer details down, but it's still possible. 1, 2.
Merchant! Bearing! 1. 3. 1. 2. Closing!
Good. All right, so I need my pencil, please. Okay, there it is. Final speed, more or less. 750, so he's the same. Let's take a look. Does look like a split freighter of some kind. I'm not sure which kind, because the masts is a telltale, and so is the shape.
Closing.
Alright, well, we're probably gonna fire here. Just see, we'll use tube 7 and 8 this time. We're only gonna fire 2. Okay. So if we're gonna fire there, the angle on bow needs to be like that. Speed needs to be there. And the range, it's pretty straight, so I'm okay with that. So he needs to be around 170, so we're gonna check up on him when he's more like it, 135. So let's see what happens when he's at 135. Might be able to tell what he is. Okay.
Bearing 1, 1, 7.
Try 135. Get my guidebook out here. Okay, so he might be a large split, actually. But we'll see.
Bearing 1, 3, 6. Bearing.
I don't know, you guys. That's looking the part to me.
7.
Got the little bit of a raise there. Got the straight deck with a little bit of a flare. Got the right masts. The bridge looks right. There's the little funnels. The funnel's about the same height. I'm thinking it's this guy, which is great news, because he's a big one. Alright, so check on him. Get a tentative range. It's more or less to get the range dial set up. Not to get some actual range. Okay, so... Oh, you know what we need to do, actually? So we need to get a 90, an exact 90.
Yes, sir. Current speed, 1.
Go ahead and start the engines. So we're gonna might need to turn here.
Bearing, 1, 4, 1.
A little more. Perfect. Alright. That's alright. We have time.
Bearing. 1, 4, 3.
Alright. No, we're good. Wait, 127. 127 it is.
Bearing. 1. Yes, sir. 4. New course. Yes, sir. 2, 7.
Haha. See, I was off. So that would have really screwed up my calculations. Alright. So we don't need that anymore.
Bearing. 1, 4, 5.
Okay, so... let's go ahead and open those, since we're not doing anything better. So we're good there. Get the big red button out of my face, because I don't want to accidentally push it. Your draft 28, so he's way the heck up here, so we can go ahead and
bearing. 1, 4, 6.
I'll go with 12.
Bearing. 1, 4, 7.
Okay. 47.
Bearing. Yes, sir.
Slow down.
4, 8, 0.
Thank you. Okay.
Bearing. 1.
49, so he's here. So we'll check up on him again when he's at about 160. In the meantime, I'm going to...
Bearing. 1. 5. 0.
I think they're a little bit off.
5, 2.
Let's take a look.
Bearing. 1, 5, 3.
Yeah, they're a little bit behind them. Alright. So.
Bearing. 1, 5.
We're gonna need a range 4. Here. Oh, yep, I already have a circle.
Bearing. 1, 5, 5.
So we're going to put in 2250 for the range.
Bearing. 1, 5, 6.
Which is roughly there.
Bearing. 1, 5.
Good enough.
7.
Oh, so you changed it. Oh, that's right. You have to put the scope right where you're aiming.
Bearing. 1, 5, 8.
Alright. Now update that. Okay, we're ready.
Bearing. 1, 5, 9.
It's really looking the part to me.
Bearing. 1, 6, 0.
We're gonna fire at 170, so we're right there. Alright, so now the hard part is predicting what he's gonna do, because I guarantee you he's gonna be able to see these. So I'm gonna shoot.
Bearing. 1, 6, 2.
I have to set myself up here. to figure out about how far ahead I need to shoot. That's always the tricky part. Probably gonna shoot right at the bow. In case he decides to speed up.
Bearing 1, 6, 5.
And where is am I gonna put the second one? See, if it was a destroyer, I'd be shooting right here. But it's not a destroyer. Let me shoot right about there. Space these out. Yep. Alright, we should be alright with that. Okay, there they go. See, I can see him like plain as day. Alright, let's go to the torpedo map like we always do. Get rid of those. Alright, there they are. Remember, I aimed right about here and here. God, this part always freaks me out because they always look like they're gonna miss. Like, oh, they're gonna overshoot, they're gonna overshoot. But then they don't. But he's gonna start seeing them pretty quick here. There he goes. He saw them.
Constant distance.
But it doesn't matter. It's too late.
Bearing 1, 7, 6. Constant distance.
It's too late, son.
Merchant. Bearing 1.
Boom. Direct hit.
Constant distance.
And he's on fire, and he's dead. Yes, good. Do we get a second torpedo hit? I don't even really need one, but where's the second torpedo? Ah, there it is. Adding insult to injury. Excellent. Alright, so we're done here. Let's lower the scope. We can resume our speed, resume our depth, resume our course. We're out of here. Alright, let's erase all this crud. Oops, a little bit more, I think. Yep. Excellent. Let's watch us surface, because it's a glorious day to be a submariner. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful seas. Alrighty, so our surface detection radar is up, our air detection radar is up. We're not seeing anything going on. Ship is above water. Crew should be returning to their posts. And we're away. Excellent. So pretty. Okay, so there's a ship, see, right in our area. Beautiful. Let's get over there, shall we? Anyway, since we're in the transit part of the mission, how was your guys' day? Me? It was really slow. It was really dead at work today, and nothing really interesting happened. Nothing whatsoever. Just, we're in that weird part of the year where, well, I stack produce for a living. I don't mind telling you guys that. So we're out of the stone fruit season, which is like the pears, or no, not the pears, the nectarines, all that stuff. Excellent. So we're kind of running out of that stuff because it's going out of season. But then we're not really in the apple season yet, and or the potatoes. Like, we're getting a few summer squashes, but no one really cares about those. They're just here because they look pretty. You know, that's their main purpose in life, is to look pretty. Let's go more like that. So yeah, it's just like kind of, we're just kind of in this dead zone where we're just waiting for Thanksgiving to kind of happen. Other than that, not much is going on. The thing is, we still need the full crew because we need them to be trained up so that when Thanksgiving does happen, it's gonna be like ridiculous. Ooh, goody. Good, you. Thank you. You're such a team player. Well, of course, I'm gonna. You know what, though? It just turned to dark, didn't it? So I'm gonna have to track this guy for a while. That's cool. At least I think it just turned to dark. Yeah, it just turned to dark. Alright, so we're tracking this guy. He's going like north. Oh, we'll
Yes,
guess
sir.
right there.
New course. Four.
Yes, sir.
Do it. Oop, a little bit more that way. Too much that way. There we go. So we'll just shadow him for a little while. We'll go. Oop, changed course. Again, so we'll just shadow him. What the frag? Go faster too. That should help keep us out of his line of sight. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and four. So it really doesn't matter at this point which way we attack him, does it? So I'm just gonna do a front attack because that's the easiest thing for me to do right now. All right, so let's see. That's roughly southwest
Yes,
a
sir.
little bit.
New course. 2, 6,
What does the weather look like? It looks calm. This part of the world is really calm right now. Shouldn't be. I'm blowing up ships left and right. Turning, turning, turning. We'll go ahead and go full speed ahead so we can. Oops. Guaranteed get there in time. Which I'm not anticipating much of a problem. Because he's going slow and we're going, 21 knots, so we should be fine. Alright, so the question is how far away is he from me? Or what, like. Alright, we need to stop right here. Go decks awash. So pretty! God, I never get tired of looking at it. Never. Unless I've been playing it all freaking day, and then I'll, of course, get tired of looking at it. Alright, so. How far are we away from the line? We want to be a little bit. Yeah, so that's fine, because we're going to have to accelerate to fix our 90 degree anyway. So that's what we kind of want, to be a little bit far away. Usually dive around 7.5. But, how low I am on the water, it really doesn't matter if I'm a little bit over. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're good. We'll zoom this back to 5. Then he'll approach and we'll get a listen. Come on, you. Oh, that bugger.
Current depth, 4, 0.
Yeah, that's not gonna work. Let's see. We're gonna have to,
Yes, sir. New depth, 2, 9.
Yes, sir.
He changed direction again. So, this is what we're gonna do. Service the boat. Sort of. Do it. Why do you look so beautiful? Why? Oh, I know he's spotted. Where exactly is he spotted again? How far away are we? A little over 5, so we're gonna have to widen the distance quite a bit. Of course, he's at, you know, 5 miles, so we're probably not going to see anything. But the reason why we're going decks awash is because we don't want to give away our position so much, but we want to use the diesel engines, not the battery. We're just basically widening the distance right now. So as a precautionary measure, go ahead and use the thingy to tell us. We'll surface... boat. Man, what is up with this guy? What is he doing? Alright, it should be safe to... Whoops. Surface. Okay. So we're gonna angle in to kind of track you now. Now he's going fast. Strange. Well, pedal to the metal, guys. He's gonna beat us if we're not careful. Let's angle in ever so slightly. And this isn't even all the calculations. He changed course like 3 times, so we'll enjoy sinking this guy. Alright, so we're gaining some distance, so I feel safe to angle in more, because we do not want him to get lost on radar. What did I just click? That's not what I wanted. That's not what I wanted at all. You know, if we have to keep going away from him, we'll keep going away from him. That's fine. He probably got the report that there was a submarine operating in this area, and then he decided to bugger out. It's probably exactly what happened. Let's see, what's this? Ship slow. Alright, let's try to get a line. Should be totally fine. Get all up in his grill. Dive the boat a little bit because it helps slow it down, believe it or not. Okay. Alrighty. Let's see if he's going to do that again.
Merchant! Closing! Bearing! 2, 6.
So this is probably a medium split freighter. Probably.
Merchant! Bearing! 2, 6, 4. Closing!
Well, they say he's moving fast, so let's... you know, let's just see how fast is, right? Let's find out. 1 minute. He's probably going at this speed, I'm gonna guess 12 knots. Alright, let's see how fast is.
6, 5, closing. Merchant, bearing.
Well, two, I was almost right. He's six, going 11.
6, closing.
Follows that line, we are really close to his track. First glimpse. Oh, it might be a big one. This might be one of them big ones that we're after. Just gonna... Whoops. There he is. Not quite as big as this guy, but still, you know, relatively big.
Relieve the watch!
But hey, if that's the guy that we're gonna get, you know, I don't have a problem with that. Got two big ones. Bigger, smaller one with the cannon. Bigger. Big. Biggie big. And some guys with the cannons. So yeah, I'm not gonna complain. That's totally worth torpedoes. Alright, let's... wrong button. Let's see what he does.
Merchant! Bearing! 2, 6, 7. Closing!
Eh, yeah, glitched out. Oh, well, whatever. Do 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 do. Come on, you. Do not change course on me again. I'm gonna use it right here. This is the final speed check. Go. Give up. Ooh, crap. Crap, 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 crap. I forgot, 16 is the fastest you can go while still keeping the clock, and then when you zoom out, or untime accelerate, it'll still be there. I forgot about that little snappy snap. Roger, Dodger. What's he got? 12. Alright, 11 or 12. Alright, Periscope, reveal to me. He's indeed one of the big ones.
It's
a draft of 24. Alright, let's get a line, because we... Oh, hang on. Wrong button. I need a line, because this is not perfect.
Merchant, bearing 2, 8, 3. Closing.
So don't worry, guys. We still have plenty of time to fix this. But we want to fix it now, so we don't have to worry about it later. A little more. This has to be really good, because he's probably going to see these.
8, 4. Closing.
Okay, that's probably good enough. Alright, so let's start getting the boat moving.
Yes, sir. Current speed, 1. Yes, sir. Merchant. Bearing. 2, 8, 2, 5. Closing.
23. 20.
Yes, sir. New course. 2, 2, 4. Yes,
good
sir.
Enough. Get that happening for me, please.
Merchant.
That's gonna bearing. Put him closer.
2, 8, 6. Closing. Merchant. Bearing. 2, 8, 9.
600. Alright, so let's see, we're gonna do a front attack, right?
Merchant.
So we're gonna use
bearing.
5 and 6.
Nine.
5 and 6 are indeed ready. Our standard depth is sufficient.
2, 9.
Put them at
6. Closing.
Put them at 11 and a half.
Merchant.
I guess.
Bearing. 2, 9, 9. Closing.
Okay.
Merchant. Bearing. 3, 2.
Do here then.
Merchant, bearing 3, 0, 3. Closing.
1 and a half off. So that's 1 and a half off.
Merchant, bearing 3, 0, 5.
Good.
Closing.
All right. Calculations
Merchant,
are tentatively ready.
Bearing,
tubes are ready.
Three,
flooded
seven,
and ready.
7. Closing.
Still turning.
Merchant. Bearing. 3, 0, 8. Closing.
Just gotta wait a little bit longer.
Merchant, bearing 309.
Closing.
Merchant, bearing 310.
I'd buy that. Alright, so we're good. So slow down by a lot. You can see that reflected in the gauges here. Our RPMs is virtually nothing. And, you know, obviously, barely spinning the propellers. God, it just looks so beautiful. I would love to go see one of these things in real life. And be able to go in a submarine. I think I did that a few times when I was a kid, but like I didn't truly appreciate it. You know what I mean? It's like when you're an adult, like, you know, going campfires and all that fun stuff. When you're a kid, it's like, yeah, it's fun, but when you're an adult, you're like, yeah, campfires, woo, yeah. You know, it's like it's different. Because it's not work. Okay. How accurate are you, sonar man? This is your test. Beautiful. He is perfect today. Alright, so we said we're going to fire at 345. So let's go ahead and accelerate time. Because while I don't... Oh, shit. Oh, I don't want to waste your guys' time. I want to also enjoy the game. Alright, so he's probably going to see, so let's see.
Merchant, bearing three,
here.
Constant distance.
And these are the last of our torpedoes, so...
Bearing three, firing two, six, four. Constant distance.
You know, so what you see is... What you see there is what you get.
Merchant.
Alright, so we got two on their way. You should have about a minute wait. Where the torpedoes go? Ah, there they are.
Merchant, bearing 3, 4, 9. Constant distance.
I know, right?
Merchant, bearing 3.
Here they come.
Constant distance.
Merchant. Here they come.
3, 5, 2.
Alright.
Constant distance.
So any second now we should be able to see them. He's gonna probably turn to port.
3, 5, 4.
He hasn't seen them yet.
Constant distance. Merchant. Bearing.
I don't know if he's seen him or not.
Five.
Oh, there he is. Start turning to starboard. He's seen him.
Merchant. Bearing. 3.
Unfortunately for you.
Constant distance.
Ooh, dude, that was a direct on the second it hit. That's fantastic. He sped up though, so this one's gonna hit way back here if it hits at all.
Bearing. 3.
Damn it.
Eight.
Okay. We can still sink him though, right?
Bearing 3, 5, 9. Constant distance.
We can still sink him, right?
Bearing 1.
With that one
constant
hit.
Distance.
I mean, it didn't really hurt him, but he is going down slightly.
Constant distance.
All right, thank you, sonar. You're no longer required. Oh, he's going down a little. Whoop. I think he's done. I think he's going down. Yep, there goes his decks. Shall we take a look? Probably dead by the time we get there. Yep, he's underwater. Propellers are actually helping you push yourself into the water. I don't think they got their watertight doors sealed in time, so Yes, look at this ultimate Titanic sinking. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh, come on, snap in half. Snap in half, you. Snap in half, you. Come on, snap. Ah, it didn't snap in half. That would've been amazing. Is it gonna bob there for a second? Did they get the watertight doors sealed in the back? Or is it just gonna go under? It feels like it's slowing down. Come on, come on. Back up. Go back up. Come on, you can do it, buddy. Oh, oh. I think she's done. I think we're done. Yeah, she's going under. Oh, that was beautiful. Excellent. Man, look at those calculations just for that one little guy. All right, let's go ahead and go back to our patrol. Yeah, that was lovely. All right, so we're gonna radio command and see what they think of our kill. Yep, we do not need the periscope anymore. We have radar, we have deck watch people that are gonna go up there as soon as it's safe to do so. Whoa, explosions underwater. But we don't care what's going on underwater right now. We care about what's going on in the surface. All right, crew, more than happy to get back on the boat. Thank you. All right, so let's radio command. Yep, but that's not what we care about. We want sent. 50,000 tons sunk. Excellent. 7 torpedoes left. Cargo ships, tankers. Beautiful. Alrighty, so we're on our way to the next patrol zone. We'll just time accelerate through it. And any second now, we'll get the message saying we are in our patrol zone. Oh crap, they're getting curious about what the heck's going on. That's a plane. Yeah, I'd be that way too. I mean, I just lost a freaking, what'd we sink recently? Yeah, just lost 16,000 tons and 16. What? Yeah, that's right. I can do math. Oh, shit. You see how he was going that way, but now he's going this way? I think we're spotted, you guys. Oh, no. Get back in the boat. Get in the boat. It's very dangerous to be there right now. Alright, so we need to do a turn. Yes, sir. Rudder 3-8. Yes, sir. Do a turn and speed the heck up. That'll really screw this guy up. Because now he has no idea. He can't see us anymore. He can't radar track us anymore unless they have sensors I don't know about. Alright, so that'll give us a new course. Rudder 0. And. Not one starboard, I'm at zero. Thank you. Thank you. And that'll give us a new location of what he's expecting, so he shouldn't be able to find us. Alright, so we're under the sea. I'm gonna poke. Probably about now, maybe.
Single contact. Bearing 3-2.
Yes, sir.
Long range.
New depth 1-6-5.
Yes, sir.
Stay down. Not worth it. However, we can get back to our course. That'd be lovely. We can delete that line, I think. let's go ahead and poke again. Alright, we're good. Whew, that was a little bit intense. Alright, so we're in our patrol zone. And we are patrolling.
Message received.
Oh, okay, cool. What do we get? We got... Okay, Kiska. So if you've been with me before, you know that Kiska is way the hell up here. And we're nowhere near there, so we're gonna ignore that. We have our orders to patrol this part of the East China Sea, which is really close to the Formosa Strait, which if we don't find anything here, I guarantee you, Command is gonna tell us to go here, here, or the Luzon Strait. I guarantee you that much. So, we're just sneaking into our area in the dark of night. Really, we wanna be up here. So I'm going to cancel that maneuver because this is really where we want to be. We got us a ship. Oops, let's go. Oops. Let's get a line. Because it's only going to be daytime by the time we shoot at this guy. So let's go northeast-ish. Okay. Right. Let's time accelerate just to get through this. He's going fast. We're not gonna mess around here. Obviously stalling out a little bit because as you can see it's very dark. So we're stalling a little bit, and that's fine. So like I said before, he changed course. I should be thanking you guys, really, because it makes it so much more fun. Ooh, crap. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Okay. Ooh, I thought I lost him. Let's go directly south then. Yeah, I should be thanking you guys because this makes it a lot more fun and challenging and interesting for me to play.
Single contact, bearing 9, long range.
No, we're still very, very dark though. Remember, I got like this much wiggle room that I can have him. So I'm letting him get a lot closer. But we're gonna go ahead and go full. Okay, he's going medium, so we'll go standard. As we go east, oh crap, he's going northwest. Or northeast, sorry. I know my lefts and rights. Now he's going fast, so he must have gotten word that there's a submarine in the area. No, it's just not good enough. That's good enough. Alright, cool. So we have three different lines on this guy already. Let's go ahead and slow down. Fuel is becoming more of a concern, honestly. But that's alright. What's it look like out there? It's starting to get light. Just starting to. It's probably about 9 o'clock. 9:30. Okay, this should be light enough by the time we engage, so we're gonna go ahead and engage. For that though, we need a line. It needs to be pretty dang accurate. I'm gonna keep all these other lines here because I like to see how long I've had to hunt this guy. All right, so we're gonna go. Probably do an aft attack, honestly, because that's where most of my torpedoes are at this point. So to do that, we need to go Oh, I don't even really, it doesn't matter whenever you do this anyway. Just need a rough idea. About 3:30. There you are, go.
Yes, sir. New course. 3:30.
Go. And of course you can slow down a little bit, I think. Maybe not that slow. Alright, and we want... Yeah, he's far away though. So there we go, there's our safety zone. And then from this point... Oh my gosh, he changed course a freaking again. Of course he did. Alright, go. Go, 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 go.
Yes, sir.
Wait.
New course. Two.
Southeast.
New course. 1, 3, 2.
Alright, these guys are getting smart. These guys are getting smarter. But we're gonna get them anyway. Maybe not exactly directly south, but... What the heck? I thought it was getting lighter. I don't know, this is weird. Weather's being weird. I don't know, guys. Whatever, we have the clock. Kinda help us out. I'm gonna greatly enjoy sinking this guy. Although I have a feeling that after I do so, it'll be the end of the episode, because I feel like it's been about where I want it to be. Okay, slow the boat down. Thank you. Reduce the time, check. Yeah, it's getting lighter. It's just, it's being weird how it's doing it. Like I said before, this game tends to be a little bit glitchy. Alright, go ahead and stop
yes,
it.
Sir. I'll stop.
Yes, sir.
Alright, so we want to set up a safety zone here. So you better not change course. If you do, I'll be upset. Just prepare the boat to dive. We're not actually diving yet. And now we're diving. Alright, so we can get away with using that circle. Comes and gotcha.
Current depth 4.093.
Closing. Merchant. Closing.
Alrighty. There and reveal unto me
bearing
your speed.
1, 2. Bearing 9, 2.
Great. There. Pixels on the... I guess it's like the pixels on the screen or on the map aren't exactly right, but it's good enough. Alright, so we got a speed of 9 knots so far. That's doable. Question is, how far are we away from him? We are right on top of him. But we wanted to do an aft attack,
yes,
so
sir.
Let's go ahead and set that up.
Yes, sir.
I think we wanted to do an aft attack. Yes, we did. So we're going to have to go
sir.
A little bit faster.
Ahead,
go south. We are under the water. This is about how bright it's gonna be, more or less. Sun's fully in the sky.
Merchant! Bearing! 8, Closing.
I don't want to be at 8-3. Maybe a little more that way. We don't want to turn too much because that slows us down. But we want to be across this line. We're going the same speed now, so this should not be a problem. But if we go faster... So you want to be far away from him. Come on, submarine. Get across his line.
Merchant. Bearing. 7.
Oh, I feel sorry for the guys trying to make these kinds of calculations in the,
because
there's so many variables that are going on right now to calculate the speed. It's like, this should be impossible for anyone to figure out.
Merchant. Bearing.
I'm sure it's not. I'm sure they have classes and stuff, but I would not want to try because basically he's
closing.
Going straight at you, so you have to base it on volume alone, and that's just not good enough.
Merchant, bearing 9-6.
Yes, sir.
Closing.
All right. So yeah, the submarine's going to continue to drift,
bearing,
but we just cannot
9-7.
Have that closing. That loud of an engine happening right now. Fuel is about 55%. This is actually. I know it takes about 30% to get, I give myself 30%, so we got about 20% to play with.
Merchant, bearing 9-8, closing.
Man, look at these calculations, look how dense the map is getting right here with all these little lines. I kind of want to slow down even more, just because I don't want him to see the periscope trail, because I need to get a visual.
Merchant, bearing 9-9, closing.
So once we get down to like 2 knots, we should be okay. But we're not at 2 knots. We're at 2.5. Okay, 2, good enough. Alright, let's see here. Okay, so from this angle, I cannot tell what it is, but I know where he is. Wow, you're way off today, sir. This must be an inexperienced operator. Let's go under and listen to ourselves. Alright, they said he's at 100. I'd say it's more like at 102. Actually, let's wait. There you go.
Bearing 101. Closing.
I'd say it's more like at 102, 103. Just based on the sound alone. What do you guys think? Alrighty, what we need is a line then. Reveal to me what you are doing. Oh, beautiful. That's like perfect. Oh wait, no, it's not. It's almost perfect. Let's be just slightly adjusted.
Merchant, bearing 102, closing.
Just eyeballing it, that should be good enough. Well, double, yeah, no, that's fine. Maybe 1 degree lower, but not really more than that. It's gonna be good enough. Okay, give me a 90 for you. Oops, that's definitely not good enough. No excuses here, this is easy. Come on. Alright, so the actual course we want is 174. 6074.
New course. 175.
Good enough.
Bearing 104.
Okay.
Closing.
He said he was going 9 knots or something like that. 8.5. We can do another speed check if we wanted to. Why the heck not? Be more precise.
1, 0, 5.
Do it. 1, 2.
Merchant. Bearing. 1, 3.
Oops. Pencil. There. Okay.
1, 2. Closing.
See, now he's going 9.5. Okay.
Merchant. Bearing. 1, 1. Merchant spotted. Closing.
Still on that line, so we're good. He just changed his speed. And this looks like one of them small ones.
Bearing. 1, 1, 4. Closing.
Alright, so if this is one of the small ones, then we're gonna stop the episode because I don't really feel like shooting him because we're already really close to the end.
Merchant. Bearing. 1, 1.
A little bit more detail here.
Closing.
That should be more than enough to tell. Yeah, this is a small one. So we're going to end the episode here because shooting at a 2,000 ton ship isn't worth it for me for how close we are. So I'm going to go ahead and pause, save the game right now. There it will be for next episode. Until then, guys, run silent, run deep.